Many applications have radial symmetry. So instead of the Buckley-Leverett problem in rectilinear coordinates, you will get it in radial coordinates. Does that matter a lot? Sometimes, yes. So let us start with the derivation of the governing equations. As you will see in this video, they are very similar to the ones you know, apart from some factors R. So let us take a look. So take a look at two-phase flow. Two phases, say water and oil, for example. So here they are. As I are the saturations, we're looking at radial flow. So we assume that they are only depend on the radial coordinates R and time t. So no dependence on theta and z. And two-phase flow, so the sum of the saturations has to be equal to 1 as usual. What about the velocities? Well, the velocities are purely in the r hat direction. So we have two velocities, water velocity and oil velocity. We call the sum the total velocity, and both depend on r and t. And then finally, we have some pressures, p, also depending on r and t. And as usual, the capillary pressure, the difference between non-wetting and wetting pressure, which is p oil minus p water. So we typically think of a well problem with Rw as the range of the well, which is typically, say 0.1 meter, and R reservoir, the range of the reservoir, which is typically like a kilometer or something like that. So the picture is not to scale, of course. And then we are interested in the saturations at a certain distance of the well. We are interested in the velocity fields at the distance of the well, pressure. So what are then the governing equations? Now, first of all, we have mass conservation for water. That's the equation over here. The first term here remains the same, but the divergence operator simplifies a lot, because we only have R dependence and only flow in the R direction. So the divergence operator simplifies to only one term, 1 over R times ddR of R times Uw. Same for oil mass conservation. This term over here remains the same, and again the divergence operator simplifies a lot. Becomes even nicer if we add those two equations, because then the first term yields phi times the ddt of SO plus SW, but SO plus SW equals 1 is a constant, so the ddt equals 0. So you only are left with the sum of those two terms, the ddr of r times u w plus u oil, which was u total. So adding those two equations yields a really nice and easy equation for u total. So that's about the mass conservation. Moving on to Darcy, Uw water velocity equals minus water mobility times the pressure gradients. We have flow only in the R direction, so P depends on R, so the gradient of pressure reduces to dP dR, still partial derivatives because the pressure may depend on time. Similarly for the equation for oil. Then earlier we learned how to express Uw then in terms of U total and in terms of capillary diffusion and dSwdr. The derivation goes exactly the same. So you can express your water velocity in terms of your total velocity times Fw, which is the lambda W divided by lambda W plus lambda oil, and your capillary diffusion. Now, then we can summarize. Now we have the equations of our problem. A second equation here is this one. That's an easy one in this case. First equation expresses the mass conservation of water. It's this one over here, where we substituted for Uw, this expression over here. So then you get a term with R times Fw times U total, which is over here, and you get a term with R times D cap times dSwdr, which we brought to the other side over here. So now we have two nice equations. One equation fixes your U-total. And once you have your U-total, you can plug it in over here. I have a partial differential equation for SW. I notice that it's very similar to the one in rectilinear coordinates, apart from a few factors R, which are creeping up here and there and there and there. So you have a few additional factors of R, but apart from that, your radial Buckley-Leverett equation looks very similar to your rectilinear one.